everyone. Thank you for joining us tonight. It has been quite some time since I was able to film with a friend, so it's really nice to see Jenny this evening. And it's been a very long time since she has had a little bit of pampering as well, so it would be nice to do a little treatment on her tonight. So, as you can see, I am talking through this video. I'm going to see how it sounds with wearing a mask and kind of make the decision whether I can start talking through videos again for you. But obviously, if it doesn't sound great, then we can go back to voiceovers. But I know a lot of you asked for me to start doing videos where I talk through them again. So here we are. So we're just going to do a replenishing facial for Jen tonight. Like a lot of you, I'm sure, she has a little bit of maskne, and we're just going to do a really nice cleanse for her. So I'm just going to start with brushing through her hair. There's not really any reason to do this apart from relaxation. I mean, who doesn't like to have their hair brushed? I'm sure a lot of people in the UK are already booked in with their hairdresser and cannot wait. grab a headband. If you just lift your neck up, Jen, just grab your hair. Great, thank you. Does that feel okay? It's not too tight, is it?
No.
Right, so we're going to move on to the facial now. And I'm actually going to wear some gloves for this part, for the cleansing and the exfoliating. And that's only because my hands have been a little bit sensitive over the past month or two. They've just been in water and bleach and everything way too much. So I'm trying to save them. So for this part, I will wear gloves, but obviously a lot of you like the sound of gloves. So hopefully you will enjoy this. Some warm water and some mitts here. So I'll just soak them in the water and just dampen down Jen's skin. Just trace them across her skin. And her neck as well. Just to add a little bit of moisture to the skin. And then I have this oil to foam cleanser from Rayol Beauty, and I really enjoy using this one actually. It's really good. It smells amazing as well, and it foams up really nicely, so we'll be using that one today. So I'll take 2 pumps and grab some water as well. As you can see, it starts to foam up. And I'll start massaging it into Jen's skin. Grab a little bit more water. And I'll just work it into the chin area as well. So I'm being quite gentle because obviously I don't want to hurt Jen if she's got an uncomfortable pimple there or anything. Working my way up the face, gently massaging the nose area as well, because obviously this can get a little bit congested, and then going onto the forehead, circular motions, and then gently around the eyes. And you want to massage a cleanser in for at least a minute so that you get the full benefits of the cleanser. And then I'll take my mitts again and I'll gently wipe away the cleanser from Jen's face. Did that cleanser feel okay on your skin?
Yes.
So that line, Rail Skincare, is, I believe, designed around your hormonal month.
Mm.
So it's good for breakouts and inflammation and things like that. So that's why I thought it might be good to use on you tonight.
Mm.
It smells really nice as well. So your skin's looking a lot more plump now. It's looking a lot more hydrated, so that's kind of telling you that it's quite thirsty at the moment, so it needs hydration more than anything, so more water-based products. So I'm going to use a gentle exfoliator on you today, and the one I have is from Indeed Laboratories, and it is a rice bran powdered exfoliator, and I've used this before, it's really good. So I'm just going to take a good amount of this in the palm of my hand. And again, you just add a little bit of water to the powder just to emulsify it. And this goes quite foamy, so you will feel like little bits of the rice bran, but it shouldn't be too harsh on the skin. I really like using this exfoliator. I just find it's a perfect balance for any skin type, really. And again, I'll just gently massage it into her skin. Mainly her chin area. Do let me know if anything feels, you know, uncomfortable on the skin. I mean, this should be okay. It's only got pineapple enzyme in and rice bran, but just let me know. Again, just getting the nose. The side of the nose as well. And bringing it up to the forehead. I'm not going to go too close to Jen's eyes because obviously it's an exfoliator and it's not really necessary to be placed just underneath the eye area, so the chin, the cheeks, the nose and the forehead. And again, you want to massage this in for at least a minute, just so that it can kind of cling onto any dead skin cells and release them from the surface of the skin. So we'll rinse that off for Jen now. So Jen does have a little bit of colour in her skin now, a little bit of heightened colour, but that's only from the exfoliator and it's mainly around her chin area. So what we will do now is just calm the skin. So we're going to use really nice, soothing, calming products for the remainder of the facial now for Jen. Does your skin feel okay?
Yes.
Looks really nice actually. Mm. It looks really nice and glowy already.
That's lovely.
Okay, so I'll remove the gloves now. So it feels quite smooth actually. Mm. Feels really nice.
Good. It's because you worked your magic.
It's not over yet. usually after you've left it a few minutes, it can go a little bit dry.
Mm.
After the cleanse, but no, it feels nice. But let's get some hydration into there now. Okay, so I'm going to use a serum, and this is actually from Function of Beauty, and this was customized for me. However, Jen's skin is very, very similar to mine at the moment, so I wanted to try it out on her, and if she gets on with it, then she could put an order in herself. So take a nice amount, and it comes in a really nice bottle with a pipette style dropper, which is very handy really. So I'll take a couple of drops. Start to massage that into the skin. I find that this is kind of like a middle ground between a serum, and it does have like a slight oil-like texture. However, it does melt into the skin really nicely. So you kind of get the benefits of both really with this product. It has some slip to it, so you can massage it nicely into the skin. It doesn't kind of get sucked up into the skin too quickly. You can kind of give a nice massage for a few minutes with this product. Does that feel okay?
Yes.
Massaging it around the eyes and the forehead as well. Just using my fingertips, really. Okay, so that has sunk into the skin nicely. So I'm going to go on and use a moisturiser now. And again, this is the moisturiser from Function of Beauty. I wanted to also try this out on Jen's skin tonight. So I can't remember if these are scented or not. Was that serum scented?
No. I can't. Not overly.
I've got a mask on, but do you want to give that a sniff?
No.
No, they must. I must have gone for the non-scented because I've got sensitive skin. Yeah. So I'll just take a good amount of this as well. And this one hasn't been used. This is a new order, so this moisturiser is really nice as well. It's quite light based, so it doesn't feel heavy on the skin. And it's very cooling as well, I find. Hmm. So again, I'll just apply a little bit onto the neck, the chin, the cheeks, the nose, and the forehead to start with. And then I'll just start to massage that into the skin as well. But I'm not going to massage this moisturiser in too much because I'm going to use the ice globes on Jen's skin in a moment. So I'll just rub it into a point where it's not laying on the surface of the skin, but so that it's still got enough on the skin for the ice globes as well. Okay. I love that sound. So I'm going to take my ice globes, and these are going to be gold. They've just come out of the fridge, so just warn you, Jen. Have I used these on? Yes, I have, haven't I? Yeah. It feels a bit intense to start with, but it's so nice after a little while.
It's really nice.
Once your skin gets used to it. So good for the under eye area, I find, especially in the evening. And in the morning, if you've got time, but who does in the morning? I'm just going to massage the remainder of the moisturiser into her skin. You have to be quite gentle with these ice globes because they are quite thin. I used these on James the other week. He likes to come in this room sometimes, especially in lockdown, and he said, "Mummy, can you use those blue things on me?" I said, "Okay." And he was like, "Oh, they're too cold."
Eden would love it.
Yeah. Open up like a kiddie salon.
Mm.
And you want to try and work outwards on the face as well, with any facial tool really. You don't want to be obviously pulling the skin inwards, so usually you would work from the centre of the face outwards. And not only is that going to help with your skin, firming the skin and smoothing the skin, but it also helps drain any toxins from the body. And especially with the ice globes, it just helps firm the skin. And you can use the other side for more pinpointed areas if you want to massage any areas of the face. Feel quite nice. You only want to do this for a few minutes because it can be quite an intense feeling on the skin. You wouldn't want to do it for any longer than a few minutes, really. Okay, so Jen's skin's feeling a little bit of a tacky consistency, and that's good, that's what we want. We want it to just soak in over the next couple of hours, so we will leave the facial at that. And I'm just going to quickly do a relaxing neck and shoulder massage for Jen, just to finish off the treatment for her. So I have this almond oil, and I will be using this as a base oil, and I have some lavender and peppermint that I will add one drop to as well. Actually, I'll open all of these first, just to make it easier for myself. So we'll get one drop of lavender. One drop of peppermint. And you don't need a lot of essential oils because they are so powerful. And that's why we always use like a base oil as well. So that's where the almond oil comes in. I'll just mix that up. Can you smell that?
Yeah.
It smells good.
Yeah, it does.
Sometimes it's nice to just finish a treatment with a little neck and shoulder massage, just to release any tension that you might be holding from the day. So we hold a lot of tension in our neck and our shoulders, especially if you work with computers or if you're sitting at a desk for most of your day. I imagine your job's very stressful. You must hold a lot of tension in your neck and your shoulders. It's not feeling too bad at the moment. It's a little bit... little bit knotty around here. Not too bad. It's nice to massage the bottom of the ears as well, the earlobe. A little stretch. Again, it's a scenario where you can release a lot of tension. So you do have like the, what's that piercing called? For migraines. The dart. Vicky's got that, and I gave her an ear massage once and she fell asleep. She said it was really nice. Nice to press your knuckles into the tops of the shoulders as well, so you can apply a little bit more pressure that way. So I'll just do that for a moment. Stretch the neck out a couple of times as well. Just running my hands up the back of the neck. Just gently rocking the head a little bit. Again, that can help release any tension. There you have it. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this, and hopefully we can start doing a lot more treatments now. And we'll kind of get on top of the skin again.
It's been awful.
I don't think it's that bad at all. I don't think it's that bad at all. I think you've got a little bit of congestion.
Yeah. I just can't get that to go.
Yeah, so we'll work on that then. That's what we'll work on.
I've tried to be really good with skin stuff. I bought lots of things.
Yeah.
I've been reading lots of things.
Yeah, I can tell. It looks really good. Mm. It's just the...
But then I focus on that a bit, so then my forehead has been getting dry. And so I've been putting like some moisturiser, like oil serum on just my forehead.
Yeah, and that is a really good idea, actually.
Just to not get it on my chin.
Yeah, you can section your skin.
Yeah.
Because, especially if you have like combination skin. I mean, you're not going to put something on an oily chin that doesn't necessarily need to go on a dry forehead. So that's a really good idea. Yeah. So it sounds like you're doing all the right things. And it's looking a lot better than the last time I saw you. So, yeah, we'll get there.
Thanks.
Yes. You can go home now and go to sleep.
Go to sleep, yeah. I've got to work tomorrow.
Oh, boo. Let's not think about that. Right, okay.
Thank you.
Bye.